Hey there, everybody, welcome back to the Jordan Report, and I am your host, Robert Jordan. Everyone, please remember to like, subscribe, and share. Okay, guys, I carried this story back in July, and I'm going to give you an update of what's going on. They released 18,000 prisoners back in August. I reported this story at the time. Now, I'm going to give you an update as to what happened as a result of this, but I'm going to give you a review of the story. California Gavin Newsom to release 18,000 prisoners to slow the spread of COVID-19. This is what they told us back in July. I carried this story. Gavin Newsom's California is set to release a staggering 18,000 prisoners by the end of August to slow the spread of COVID-19. I'm going to show you what they did to California as a result of this. Officials in California claim that releasing the prisoners into the public will help protect the health and safety of the incarcerated population. I read that two times the last time. I'm going to read it two times this time. Officials in California claim that releasing the prisoners into the public will help protect the health and safety of the incarcerated population. These are actions that are taken to provide the health and safety of an incarcerated population and staff. We aim to implement these decompression measures in a way that aligns with both public health and public safety. An estimated 8,000 inmates could be eligible for release by the end of August, and they let them out, people. They let them out. In addition to the state's reduction of about 10,000 inmates since Gavin Newsom declared a state of emergency in March. Now, I'm going to show you the local news there yesterday, and I'm going to show you what happened as a result of these people being on the street.
At 5:30, a continued rise of murders and shootings in L.A. is causing community concerns, and it has families living in fear. NBC4 I-Team investigator Eric Leonard taking a closer look at this growing trend as the LAPD says its efforts to prevent more violence have been complicated by the pandemic and a recent police scandal.
Our family, his sisters, brothers, everybody, we really do miss him.
The family of Austin Belial says it's grateful. LAPD homicide detectives have told them the case has been solved.
And we just grateful for you guys to be able to solve whatever issue we have. We just want to say thank you guys.
Belial was killed July 31st during a robbery at 52nd and Ruth Ellen Streets amidst an unusually violent summer. According to the latest LAPD data, just in the last week, at least 12 people have been murdered, and records show reports of nearly 100 shootings have been recorded.
In the city, we had 261 homicides. That is 25% increase from last year at this point.
That's been the trend in recent weeks that's prompted social media messages like this from LAPD headquarters, showing officers are trying to find illegal guns before anyone else is shot.
We haven't seen that type of week in over 10 years.
Last week, Assistant Chief Robert Arcos told police commissioners responding to the increased violence has been more difficult. Hospitals won't allow gang intervention workers to meet with shooting victims because of coronavirus restrictions. And in the wake of a scandal involving police officers charged with labeling innocent people as gang members, the department has put restrictions on its Metropolitan Division officers, who would typically be sent into an area to stop and question as many people as possible. Instead, they'll have limited assignments.
Following up on leads, interviewing and talking to witnesses and suspects, gathering intelligence, reviewing video, and also responding to crime scenes if need be.
Now, in the Belial murder, four men are now in custody facing murder charges with gang enhancements. Detectives say some of the spike in street violence that started late last month can be traced back to an old gang feud in South Los Angeles, and it's led to a series of retaliatory shootings. We should mention other big cities around the U.S. have also reported increases in the most serious kinds of violent crime over the summer, and so far, there's not a single clear explanation anywhere of why it's happening.
Okay, the reason why it's happening is because all those places, as well as LA and California, have released all those prisoners.